This is Chile, the longest country in the world, and the country with a flag which kinda looks like Texas. Why is Chile so long and slim? Well, it is a simple obvious answer because there is a tall and long Andes mountain range which separated Chile from the rest of the South American continent, making it super convenient to just make a country out of distinct geographical features. But why the neighboring countries of Chile did not try to eat it alive since it's just some thin strips of land? Well, for context, since Christopher Columbus thought he landed in India, Spain, and Portugal colonized the crap out of South America, Chile became a part of the Spanish Empire. At first, Chile was seen as kinda useless as it has no gold or silver as compared to Peru. Chilean lands eventually became an important source of food for the viceroyalty of Peru. When Napoleon invaded Spain, the Spanish territories in South America began to push for independence. Unlike Brazil or the American 13 colonies, the Spanish South American viceroyalties did not have a united front together in their war of independence. It's more like a bunch of territories fighting their own wars against Spain, and hence lots of new countries popped up in South America after the Napoleonic Wars. Chile eventually became independent after a series of internal and external fightings, with some help of this Irish dude and this crazy Scottish dude. The newly independent Chile and Argentina both wanted Patagonia, so they raced to the south, beating up the native people along the way. Chile knew that its position is precarious, so it decided to bolster its military and naval power, which gave Chile considerable muscles in expanding its territories, improving its leverage. Eventually, Chile got control over the Strait of Magellan, but conceded all of Oriental Patagonia to Argentina, effectively making sure Chile will always be long and thin and will never get fat. Chile also beat up Bolivia and Peru, and took the Bolivian coast, making it even longer. As per the typical South American country's history, Chile has a bunch of military coups and dictators throughout its existence. Due to its relative isolation, the population of Chile has more Spanish roots as compared to its counterpart Argentina, who welcomed immigrants from all over Europe. Fast forward, during the Cold War, United States was not happy with Chile, because Chile decided to nationalize lots of American investments in Chile. Thus, United States strangled the Chilean economy, and installed this dictator on the Chilean government. Chile also supported Britain during the Falkland Wars, which made Argentina quite angry. Then, democracy happened in Chile, economic growth, trapped miners, and here we are today. The story of Chile becoming long and thin is a testament to how Chile managed to increase its muscles and expand its territories, and also a great example of how the Spanish-speaking colonies in South America were disunited following independence, unlike Brazil. If Chile was weak, all of Patagonia would probably be under Argentine control today, and Bolivia will still have its Pacific coast. Today, Chile is one of the most developed countries in South America, having a booming technology industry, and the tallest building in South America. Chile is technically a tricontinental country, having a diverse landscape and lots of beautiful natural wonders. Due to the position of Chile along the Pacific Ring of Fire, Chile experienced lots of earthquakes, to a point where Chileans are quite chilled and relaxed during earthquakes unless it's super serious. Chileans are seen as the fastest talker in South America, with an accent so thick that other Spanish-speaking South Americans could not really understand. Chileans also reckon their wine is the best, which made it a contender to who is the snobbiest dude in South America, alongside Argentina. Will Chile become longer in the future? Probably not, unless these countries decided to generously give their Pacific coasts to the almighty Chile, who knows? Thanks for watching.